The CSTR sizing problem, where we are given data in terms of the reciprocal reaction rate that often you see. These are just points basically from a Levin-Spiegel plot, where we have reciprocal reaction rate versus conversion up to a conversion of 75%. We don't have very many data points, but for this problem, we don't really need them. And what we want to do is estimate the volume of a CSTR needed to achieve 50% conversion in part A, where the reaction is A goes to products. We're given information about the volumetric flow rate and the inlet concentration. And so we just need to solve for, in part A, how to get up to 50% conversion in a CSTR. Right, as always, we'll start with a material balance on component A, which is the component of interest here. And we can write that we've written this material balance in many different forms. One of the forms that's convenient for this problem is in terms of conversion, that the volume divided by the inlet flow rate of component A is equal to the conversion of component A over the reaction rate of component A. And we want to solve for the volume in this case. We want to do so at a conversion, 50%. We also want the reaction rate, so 1 over negative RA, be equal to the value at the exit concentration because this is a CSTR. And remember, the reaction rate is occurring purely at the exit concentrations. All right, so the reaction rate is 205 in units of seconds per seconds times liters per mole, or I'm sorry, minutes times liters per mole, minutes divided by molarity. The inlet flow rate of A can determine pretty simply is just equal to inlet concentration times the volumetric flow rate. The inlet concentration is 0.8 molar. And the inlet volumetric flow rate is 1 liter per second. All right, so that means that the molar flow rate is 0.8 moles per second. All right, we have one unit conversion here that we'll need to multiply by 60 seconds to get this number into minutes per molar, but I'll not show the details of that since that one's pretty simple. That leaves our only unknown from this equation being the volume. All right, so the volume, if we solve for it, is on the order of 4,900 liters. All right, so in part B, we want to estimate the volume of a second CSTR connected in series to the one that we just solved for in order to get to 75% conversion. All right, this is a very similar type setup. And in this case, we can write the same expression. The only difference is now we look at a difference in the total conversions divided by the reaction rate. Right, because we're not starting the equation we wrote first, we assume implicitly that we start at 0% conversion. Here we're going from 50% to 75% if we have two reactors connected in series, and we already have 50% conversion entering the second reactor. Right, using this definition, we look at a drawing here, and I draw a very simple schematic of two CSTRs in series. Because we're basing our conversion values on the inlet conditions, we'll use the same FA naught we just had, which is 0.8 moles per, right? And so that's FA naught. The volume is, of course, what we want to solve for. And then the reciprocal reaction rate, right? So 1 over negative RA. Look back at our table. All right, all of the reaction in the second reactor, about the entire contents, is it a conversion of 75% with respect to the original conditions? And that means that we will be operating at a reciprocal rate of 350 minutes times liters per mole. Here we should have everything we need here. We just multiply the 350 times the 75% minus 50%, so times 0.25. All right, multiply that through by FA naught and solve for V. And so the volume we get in this case is 4,200 liters for the second reactor in the series. And so even though we're only achieving 25% more conversion, where in the first reactor we got 50%, this reactor is almost as big as the original 4,900 liter reactor. Okay, now let's move on to part C. Okay, in part C, right, and so in this case, what we're doing is we're splitting up the flow and then recombining it at the end. Right, and doing the reaction in parallel. And this scenario, where each of these has an equal volume, or even if they're not equal, when you operate CSTRs in parallel, their conditions are such that there's 75, if you're going to a conversion of 75%, then the reaction rate inside here is the same as the reaction rate inside here. Right, so they function just like a single CSTR with a larger volume because the conditions in here are everywhere the same as the conditions in here. Because of that, we can again use our same expression. So V over FA naught is equal to X2 in this case, which is equal to 75%, written right in here, over negative RA. All right, in this case, we again use 350 minutes per molar for going into the negative RA. Again, remembering we need to change the units from minutes to seconds here by multiplying by 60. FA naught is the same as 0.8 moles per second. All right, so we have everything we need here to solve for the volume. So the volume, and if we want to do this for an individual reactor, then we'll want to take to multiply, say we split the flow in half, then we'll want to multiply that quantity by 1/2. And so an individual reactor will be 6,300 liters, if I solve that right. But the two reactors together would have a total volume of 12,600, so double that. Okay, and so what we see is that the total reactor volume here is around 12,600 when we have these two in parallel. When we had the case in series, the total reactor volume is closer to 9,000. And so it takes less reactor volume to do the reaction in series. And that's more or less what Part D is about. And so it asks to, first of all, determine which one requires a shorter overall residence time. The residence time, remember, is the total volume of the system divided by the inlet volumetric flow rate. This is fixed for the two cases, but the volume varies, and the volume is smaller for the case of the reactors in series. And so the reactors in series have a lower residence time, and so because they have a required lower total volume. Right, so it takes less time in the system to achieve 75% conversion. So now we want to describe the physical explanation for our observation. And the reason has to do with the mixing conditions of a CSTR. In the case of the CSTRs in series, you have a 4,900 liter reactor that is at a conversion of 50%, and you have a subsequent reactor that's at a conversion of 75%. So that means that a good part of your reaction getting up to 50% conversion occurs at a lower reciprocal rate and thus a higher reaction rate. So the reaction is going faster in that first reactor than it is in the second. Whereas if we operate in parallel, then all of the reaction is occurring at a conversion of 75%, which is at a higher reciprocal rate and therefore a lower reaction rate. So again, this is because in here, the conversion, the reaction rate is at its final value, its lowest possible value in both of these reactors. It also is here in the reactors in series. All right, but here, the reaction can occur faster. Because it can occur faster, then we need less time for the reaction to occur, so we have a lower space time that's required for the reaction. And without writing it out, that's the physical explanation, is because you're allowing some of the reaction to occur at a lower conversion, which is where it has a higher rate.